प्रेम अपराध लक्ष्य क्षिप्ताश्च कामादि तरंग मध्य कृपामयि त्वां शरणं प्रपन्न वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम् वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम् वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम् भजामि राधां अरविंद नेत्रां स्मरामि राधां मधुरस्मिताश्रयं वदामि राधां करुणाभराद्रा ततो ममान्नस्ति गतिर्न कापि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि श्री गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरि हरि हरे राम 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 हरि हरि हरे कृष्ण 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 हरि हरि हरे राम 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 हरि हरि सर्वाग्रे.
So first of all, my obeisances to my Guru Pada Padma, Nitya Pravishtam Vishnu Pada, Astotara Shata Shrimad Bhakti Vedanto, Srila Vamana Goswami Maharaj, and to my Sannyas Guru, Nitya Pravishtam Vishnu Pada, Astotara Shata Srila Bhakti Vedanta, Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj, for my humble obeisances again and again, and also after that, my obeisances to Nitya Pravishtam Vishnu Pad, Astotara Shata Srila Bhakti Vedanto, Srila Swami Maharaj, and to present here also Prampujapad Shri Damodar Maharaj, Prampujapad Shri Bharati Maharaj, Vaishnav Maharaj, and to all the Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, so the supreme affectionate mothers, so all the Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis here, please accept my Dandavat pranams accordingly. We
এখন আপনারা শ্রী মহারাজের মুখারবিন্দ থেকে.
So we are hearing from the lotus mouth of Maharaji, the glories of the holy names. He gives mercifully to us, he told about Namatatta to us, how we should chant holy names. How should we chant holy names and how should we chant our mantra? Mahaprabhu said, there's no difference between Nama and Nami. Holy names and mantra also. The difference is that the name is in evocative case. Sambodhan Vachak. Sambodhan means if someone is far, then you how you call that person? So if someone is far, You call the person like calling hey. Like for example, we call hey Krishna. So hey is sambodhan, vocative case.
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
So we call God through the Maha Mantra. Hey Krishna, Hey Radhe, Hey Radhe, Hey Krishna. So the word hey, like we call, like the vocative case. So the nama, name of God, is in vocative case, and in accordance to Sanskrit, the mantra is in sampradan bachak, means you're surrendering your everything to God through the mantra. So you can see in the Gopal mantra and the other mantras, they have this namaha or swaha in the end of the mantra, right? Swaha means swa yourself, ha, your offering. Just like when you do havan, fire sacrifice, we offer ghee into the fire, like wood with ghee, and then we say swaha. So we say swaha, but the person who is performing the fire sacrifice, like the Brahman, is saying swaha, and those who are performing the fire sacrifice, then there's like aha. The Brahman who is performing the fire sacrifice for you, he's swaha, but you're aha, like I'm hungry. Okay, so swaha. Swa is like you're offering yourself. So if you give something, surrender something, cannot take it back. Cannot take it back. So when you perform fire sacrifice, so you're offering yourself, you cannot take it back. Take yourself back. What is the meaning? I'm offering my soul and myself to the feet of Guru and Krishna. So the mantra is in sampradan, surrendering, like offering yourself, and this is the mantra. And the nama, the holy names, is in the vocative case. When you chant mantra, all your material desires will be removed if you chant the mantra. And your heart to be purified, pure, then Krishna Prema will appear in your heart. Mahaprabhu himself. What is the power of this mantra my guru gave me? Chanting this mantra, I became crazy. Now I'm only crying, laughing. Crying, laughing. So when we chant the mantra, like the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, this is the result. So this is the glories of the holy names. You chanting holy names, then you get spurti in your heart. It's visions of Krishna. Mantra will make, like holy names will make us like crazy. So Maharaj told us the glories of holy names. How we should chant holy names and our mantras also. So when you take Diksha, Sambandha Gyan arises, and immediately all the sins are destroyed. So the word Diksha means, you know that shloka? Diva Gyan will come. This transcendental knowledge, our knowledge of relationship with God. And at the same time, all our sins are destroyed.
এগুলো অনেক বিচার রয়েছে। এখন আজকে আমাদের আপনাদের কাছে আমি কাল বলতে চেয়েছিলাম।
So we told about Hera Panchami yesterday. Bengali Lal? What is the meaning of Hera? To search. If someone is really far, then you have to search for the person. If someone, you know, sometimes we have these signs of missing people. In the bus stand, they have some signs of somebody who is lost, like someone who has to be found. Sometimes we see these signs. And they offer some reward if somebody gives some news of that this person who has disappeared. So Hera means to search. So, Krishna is in Dwaraka, he took too much bath from the devotees, they bathed him so much, then Krishna became like in quarantine because he became sick with fever and cold. So after 14 days he decided to change air to go somewhere else. Lakshmidev said okay, but he didn't say, tell Lakshmidev where he was going. He didn't say. And Balaram and Subhadra, his older brother Balaram and sister Subhadra went along with him. So 5 days had passed and there was no news. Where was he? He had arrived well or not? His body was okay or not? So he didn't send any news because he was sick. So was he well? He had arrived okay or something? Nothing. No news. Then Lakshmi, she went to search her husband. This festival in Jagannath Puri is called Hera Panchami. Panchami, why is Panchami the name? You know, Panchami Tithi, fifth day of the moon. Sorry, not fifth day of the moon, fifth day since Jagannath had left the temple. Actually, Jagannath goes on the second day, so 5 days after, second day of the moon, and it was 5 days after Jagannath had left. Panchami means this, 5 days after. So Mahaprabhu was seeing like a drama of this pastime. Why? Because if you're only listening to Harikatha, the Katha will enter in your one ear and go out from the other ear. So, like you're sitting down in the Katha but thinking about your family and your house. The sadhu is giving Katha, but there was an old lady sitting in the Katha. Like, but the woman was crying, and then the sadhu asked her, why were you crying in the katha? Then actually the old lady said, I was not hearing anything. I couldn't understand anything of what you said. So why were you crying in the katha? Then the old lady said, because 3 days ago, I had a goat. You know the goat? And he had a big beard. And your beard, when you're moving your head while you speak, your beard resembles the beard of my goat. So that goat was so dear to me, you don't know. So when I used to come to the house, the goat would even like climb with his two front paws on my back. And when I see all sadhu, you're speaking with your beard also moving your head, I'm remembering my goat that it's been 3 days since he disappeared. It disappeared. So that's why the old lady was crying, because she was remembering her goat, not because of the harikata. Jagannath went with his sister and brother. So Lakshmi Devi, she was thinking, okay, 5 days he's been out and he didn't send any news, nothing. Then Lakshmi Devi became angry. Lakshmi Devi was angry. So she was angry, but how was she walking to search for him? Like, how was she going? Shastra explains. So they were also making this drama, the play of this pastime. Then Mahaprabhu asked Swarupa Damodara. Krishna was in Jagannath Puri, Nilachal, and he went to Sundarachal Gundicha temple. Sundarachal is Vrindavan. It's like symbolizing Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, Krishna performs many pastimes. Beautiful forest, a beautiful transcendental land of Vrindavan. You have been to Vrindavan, what did you see there? The Jamuna River flowing, making the sound kal kal kal. Peacock, peahen dancing. Giriraj Govardhan is also there. There are the caves of Giriraj Govardhan in which Krishna perform many pastimes with his friends, and also with the Sakis. Also Krishna meet with them in the caves of Giriraj. In the Govardhan Ashtakam, we know more about this. It's written in the Govardhan Ashtakam. So Mahaprabhu, he said, why Lakshmi Devi was not taken along with Jagannath? After all, he took only his sister and brother, but not his wife. Lakshmi Devi wasn't taken along. Why? Then Swarupa Damodara said, Swarupa Damodara said, look, listen, Lakshmi Devi, she's not qualified to enter the Leelas of Vrindavan. There's a beautiful story in this context. Have you been to Vrindavana Parikrama? Who has done the Vrindavana Parikrama? Raise your hand. Any mother who has gone? All of you come to Vrindavan, okay? When we do the Vrindavana Parikrama in the 12 forests of Vrindavan, there's one special forest called Bilban. So when our Parikrama goes to Bilban, we have the darshan of that place. In that place, Lakshmi Devi, she's performing austerities. It's the place of austerities of Lakshmi Devi. So Lakshmi Devi, she used to live in Vaikuntha. So why is she performing austerities in Vrindavan? So in this relation to this, there's a beautiful story explained in the Shastras, in the Puranas. Once, Narada Rishi, he was traveling everywhere, and then he came to Vaikuntha. He was playing his Bina, and he arrived where? In Vaikuntha. Then Narayana was not there, he was out somewhere. Lakshmi Devi was there. And then Narada Rishi said, Lakshmi Devi, how are you? She said, I'm okay, good. Lakshmi Devi asked, oh Thakur, Narada, how are you? Narada said, I'm okay, sadhus are always okay. There's nothing good or bad for the sadhus. If someone performs Bhagavad Bhajan, the person cannot be bad. The only problem for a sadhu is like, oh, today I couldn't chant properly my holy names. This is a symptom of a sadhu. This is only problem for him if he couldn't chant properly the holy names. So if you ask, Maharaj, how are you? The sadhu will always say, I am good. Or maybe the sadhu will say, I'm not okay because I couldn't chant holy names properly today. I couldn't complete my rounds, for example. Like when Mahaprabhu asked Haridas Thakur, how are you? Then Haridas Thakur said, so Haridas Thakur was not well because he couldn't chant the holy names. He couldn't finish his rounds. So in the same way, Maharaj, how are you? A high class sadhu, he will say, I'm not good. Why? Today, I couldn't do so much bhajan, or I'm not doing well. Like, I'm old time, old age has come, I couldn't do bhajan properly. This is the only problem for a sadhu, is not be able to do properly the bhajan. Do you understand Bengali? So what did I say? Old age has come. All the happiness has gone away. And I'm just suffering and pain. In the old age, there's so much pain. Your body cannot even walk properly and walk and work properly. So those who are old, they know. When the old age will come, many diseases will come in the body. Gas in your stomach. Whatever you eat, then you have gas in your stomach. Then if gas in the stomach, you cannot sleep. If you have too much gas in your stomach, you cannot properly sleep. Pain here, pain there. This body is a temple of diseases. Is there anyone who can say that I don't have any disease? Raise your hand if you have a disease. Everyone has diseases. No one can say I don't have any disease. But if you don't have any disease, you have a disease in your mind. At least, like not in the body, but in your mind, certainly you have a disease. So anyway, coming back. So, Lakshmi Devi said, how are you? Narada said, I'm okay. Everything's good. And how are you? I'm also good. Okay, so tell me some Harikatha. Lakshmi Devi said, please tell me some Harikatha. Actually, this is the duty of the sadhus. Wherever they go, sadhus have no other job, like task. Only their own one task, speak Harikatha. Somebody gives me mic, I cannot stop speaking. Maybe all the listeners will go away, but if at least one person is sitting down. So the sadhu is speaking Harikatha with his eyes shut. So sadhu is speaking for 1, 2, 3 hours Harikatha. One by one, all the people left the Harikatha. One by one, everyone's left. There's only one person sitting in front of the sadhu. So sadhu opens his eyes. Oh, there's only one person sitting. Okay. Everybody has gone. It's gone. But why are only you here left? Do you like my Harikatha? Then the person said, you are speaking for 3 hours. Then everybody left. So why are you sitting down? Oh, Maharaj, you know, because my job is to shut down the lights, shut off the lights of the temple. My duty is to close the place here. So I'm sitting here just waiting. As soon as you... I just wanted you to open your eyes to tell you it's time to stop. That's why I'm sitting here. Who is listening to Harikatha for 3-4 hours? But in front of TV, yes. You can stay whole day in front of the TV. 3 hours watching TV. And in your Japamala, you'll chant 3 lakhs Harinams, 192 rounds. Only watching TV so easily. And just like watching TV and chanting 3 lakhs Harinam. Very easy. So in 3 hours, you even chant 3 lakhs. But watching TV. Meanwhile, you watch TV. Chanting holy names, watching TV. Bola Vrindavana Bihari Lal. No, it's not possible like this. Anyway, so Narada Rishi told Lakshmi Devi, sorry, Lakshmi Devi told him, tell me some Harikatha. Then Narada Rishi, he started speaking a nice Harikatha, very nice. Which Harikatha he was speaking? Braj Harikatha of Braj. So sweet, Vrindavan Katha. Krishna Katha is very beautiful. Shastra explains in the Bhagavatam, it says, who does want to listen to Harikatha, Krishna Katha? Everyone wants to hear Harikatha. There's only one kind of person that doesn't want to listen to Harikatha. Who? In the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, we find this sloka. Nivritta Tarshai. You should memorize this verse. Which verse? Nivritta Tarshai.
Manobhirama kautama sloka gunanubada umana virajit vina pasu gna nibritta tarsha jara samsar ki samsari nitto anittota
so that person who has realized this world is so temporary and full of unhappiness, and those persons have detached themselves from this material world and they want to merge in Brahma. Even they, if they want to merge in Brahma, these people, if they listen to Harikatha, they will also give up the meditation in Brahma. We are suffering this world, Adhyatik, Adidavik, Adibhautik, even those who are burning in these three miseries. If they also hear Harikatha, Krishna Katha, even them also, all their sufferings will be removed, will end. Shastra explains.
Krishna katha sravane katha bola.
Who does want to hear Harikatha? Only one person. Who? Pashugnat, a butcher, someone who kills animals and kill animals and. They are killing living entities. It's a great sin to kill living entities, Shastra explains. Actually, someone who is sinful can never chant holy names. Even Harikatha cannot even enter the ears of someone who is that sinful, Shastra explains. So you should never do any harm to the living entities. What to speak of eating them? You should never do any harm to the living entities. These are sinful activities. Premananda Thakur said, asking your own mind, oh my mind, why don't we have taste to chant Krishna's names? Because in the previous life, committed so many offenses, so many sinful activities. By the fruit of this pap, sinful activities, we don't have taste in chant holy names in Harikatha. Kirtan explains, oh mind, why don't you have taste to chant? Because of the sinful activities of previous lives. That's why. If Krishna Katha is going on, you feel so much headache, what can I say? In the time of Krishna Katha. Troubling you so much, a headache, and you feel so sleepy. You also feel sleepy. You feel tired. You want to lay down. But if it's asat katha, mundane things, then you're so eager to listen. And You like enjoyed so much. If it's another katha, not Krishna katha, you can see that your sleepiness disappears. Whole night you can watch a football match and you'll even think about sleeping. But for 30 minutes or 1 hour or harikatha, ay Maharaj, okay, I gotta go Maharaj, okay, it's enough. So you just came here for 30 minutes and you don't want even that. So I was telling a story. Narad Rishi told Lakshmi Devi about Vraj Katha. The best, most beautiful Katha of Vraj is about the gopis. Ras Katha of gopis. Ras Lila. So Narad Rishi told how Krishna performed Rasa Lila with the gopis and he told this. Yes, very well, yeah, they spoke this word, the verse also. So Lakshmi Devi, she felt so eagerness, so much eagerness when she heard this katha. Between all the lilas of God, amongst all his lilas, the highest lila is Rasa Lila. Amongst the pastimes of Lord, the most highest is Rasa Lila. Actually, Krishna told Arjuna also, when I remember Rasa Lila, I cannot even control myself. So beautiful is the Rasa Lila. So here in the Rasa Lila, Lakshmi Devi felt in her mind lobe, eagerness. She was thinking in her mind, I also want join the Rasa Lila like the gopis. Then she told Narad Rishi, hey Narad Rishi, tell me, how can I enter the Ras? Narad Rishi said, to enter the Rasa Lila like the gopis, you must perform hard austerities, and if Krishna is pleased with you, then Krishna will allow you to enter the Rasa Lila. Then what did Lakshmi Devi do? She left Vaikuntha, she came to Vrindavan. Sorry. And she started to perform hard austerities in Belvan. Have you been to Belvan? So she was performing hard austerities there. And it was like summertime, and it's really hot. So Vrindavan is very difficult, very hard to do austerities in Vrindavan, because in Vrindavan it's too hot in the summertime and too cold in the winter time, and there is a lu, which is like a hot air. If this hot air comes in your from in your head and goes to your stomach, you start vomiting blood in the summertime in Vrindavan. So Lakshmi Devi, she was Maharani, the queen of Vaikuntha, full of many servants, female servants, maid servants. But in Vrindavan, she's performing hard austerities. One place performing hard austerities. Under the scorching rays of the sun. If you go there in Vrindavan right now, you'll understand what I'm saying. 10 a.m. already, it's so hot. What can I tell you? You become like a puri fried. So Lakshmi Devi was performing hard austerities. Seeing her hard austerities, Bhagavan Krishna appeared. Bhagavan said, hey Lakshmi Devi, what do you want? Lakshmi Devi said, Krishna, if you're happy with me, then I want to give him the eligibility to enter the Ras Lila like the gopis. Krishna said, hey Lakshmi Devi, this is not possible. This is something very rare. But I want it, she said. Then Bhagavan said, Krishna said, okay, look, if you wanted to enter the Ras Lila like the gopis, you have to follow some rules for that. First of all, you have to be born in the house of a gopi. You must take birth in Braj. If you are not born in Braj, then Bhagavan will not accept you. But this is not enough. You have to be born in Braj in the house of a gopi. And then means you have to have gopi abhiman, the ego of being a gopi. You have to be a gopi. In this world also we have abhiman, this ego. Which ego? We think I am a man or I am a woman. I am knowledgeable, I am pandit, I am foolish. I am gyani, I am scholar, I am rich, I am intelligent. We have these egos in this world. I am beautiful, I am intelligent and knowledgeable. So we have these egos, abhiman. So Shastra explains, we have to give up these material egos. If we remain with these material egos, jara, abhiman, if we cannot give up these material designations and egos, then we'll never be able to realize our soul. And we cannot do any benefit for our soul. So, Bhagavan told Lakshmi Devi, look, if you want to enter the Rasa Leela, you must take birth in Braj. Where? In the house of a gopi. From the womb of a gopi. Lakshmi Devi said, but how possible? I am a Brahmani. And the gopis, they are lower class, lower caste. Who is higher, Brahmana or Vaishya? Right? A Brahman is higher than a Vaishya. So it's not possible for me. Then Krishna said, oh, there's more. Listen. Listen up. You have to make cow dung patties. Who has done this with the cow dung here? When I was in Devananda Gaudiya Mart, I also had this seva. So we had to take the cow dung, then have to put water, make like a dough. Then you make like patties of the kaunda. It's an art how to make that. Women here, they know. Women, they work hard here, I know. So the brahmacharis in the temple, they don't do so hard work. As like the mothers. I see the hard work of the mothers, I even think. If they would be brahmacharis and living in our temples, like if these women, they would be brahmacharis and living in the temple, while the temple would be so like going so well because they serve so much. I see their service, I become amazed. I'm thinking in my mind, how much the women serve, oh my. They defeat the brahmacharis. Like they serve even more than the brahmacharis. Cooking, serving the cows, everything they do. I see the service of the mothers, I become amazed. So I'm saying Bhagavan told Lakshmi, So first of all, you have to be born in the house of a gopi. You have to take the body of a gopi, okay? Then what else? Not only that. You have to do this cow dung patties. What? Yes. My bathroom is so beautiful and nice fragrant of perfume. I have to touch in the cow dung. So my hand will be smelly for 3 days, smelling like feces. You can ask those who do that. Your hand will be smelly for 3 days. Who has done this? Cow dung patties. For 3, 4, 5 days. Your hand will smell or not? Lakshmi Dev said, how possible I do that? First of all, my body is so fragile and so not possible for me. Krishna said, oh, there's more. There's more. There's more. What? What more? Yeah, there's more. There's more. Oh, you had to marry a gopa? Marry a gopa? I only have one husband, Narayan. I'm a chaste woman. I have to marry another a gopa? Oh, no, no, no. She caught her ears like, no, not possible. Krishna said, listen up, there is more. There are more rules to enter Darasalila. Which are the rules? Okay, so you have to marry a gopa, okay? So you have to become a gopa vadu, like wife of a gopa. There's more. What? What? There's more. There's more. What? You have to meet me in the Paramur mood. When Gurudev said that this seva of cow dung was in Devanand Goryamat, I'm not sure if Gurudev said he was doing the seva or only that seva was there. I'm sorry, I translated wrong maybe, but he said that this seva was there in Devanand Goryamat. So you have to meet me in Parakya. Parakya, oh. You also have to associate with Radha and all these gopis. No, no, it's not possible for me. Okay, so you will not be able to enter the Ras Lila. So, until now, Lakshmi Devi is doing hard of Sarat Singh Dovan. So, Shastra explains. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna himself, Mahaprabhu said, like Krishna says, I am a gopa and I don't accept anyone if not a gopi. Krishna, because he's a gopi, he only accepts gopis. Krishna himself said, I don't accept anyone besides a gopi. So in this way, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, we hear about the Jagik Patnis, the wife of the wives of the Brahmanas. Wives of the Brahmanas, they came and they wanted to meet with Krishna. They said, we'll not go back to our home. But Krishna said, told them, no, go back to your house and serve your Brahmana, your husband Brahmanas. They said, no, we don't want. But Krishna insisted, told them to go away. Go away, go away. But when the gopis came, when Krishna played the flute and gopis came, instead of the wives of the Brahmanas, when the gopis appeared, Krishna also said in the beginning, go back to your house, but the gopis didn't go. In the end, they performed the Rasalila together. So Shastra explains. So taking birth in Braj. First of all, you have to be born in Vrindavan. This is the first of all. Second of all, in the house of a gopi, you have to be born there. So you have to must have the gopi sharir, body of a gopi. There are many rules. Then you have to associate with the Nitya Siddha gopis. Then in this way, you have the anuraga, deep attachment for Krishna. And as a fruit of this attachment, then you'll be able to meet with Krishna. So there are all these rules are there. I want to become a gopi, I'll be a gopi, yeah, I will be a gopi. But it takes many, many lives of perfection to be born as a gopi. Then you'll be able to attain gopi bhav. You'll be able to attain the body of a gopi. But Lakshmi Devi, she wanted in the body of Lakshmi, she wanted to enter Vrindavan and perform Rasalila. But it was not possible. So here it said,
Lakshmi Devi tar odhikar nai.
Lakshmi Devi was not qualified.
Ei jonno Krishna take sange kore niye jayen nai. Kintu tathapi ei jonno bolchen nana pushpadane totha khele ratri dine Lakshmi Devi sange nahi loy ki karone. Swarup kahe suno prabhu ihar karon Vrindavan kidate Lakshmir nahi odhikar.
So, why Lakshmi Devi was not taken along with Jagannath? She was not qualified for Vrindavan. No one can steal Krishna's mind except for the gopis. Only the gopis can steal Krishna's mind and heart.
অতএব কৃষ্ণের প্রাকট্যে নাই কিছু দোষ তবে কেন লক্ষ্মী দেবী করে তো রোষ এখন মহাপ্রভু আরেকটা জিজ্ঞাসা করলেন
মহাপ্রভু অ্যাস্ক ওয়ান মোর থিং ওকে লক্ষ্মী দেবী ইজ নট কোয়ালিফাইড ওকে টু এন্টার বৃন্দাবন ওকে দ্যাটস ওয়াই কৃষ্ণ ডিডন্ট টেক হার বাট ওয়াই ওয়াজ শি অ্যাংরি
এই প্রশ্নটা আমার মহাপ্রভু করলেন
মহাপ্রভু অ্যাস্ক দিস কোয়েশ্চন দেন স্বরূপ দামোদর স্যার
এই তো স্বভাব
This is the nature of the ones who love. The symptom of love. This anger of Lakshmi Devi was actually. She was thinking, oh, my husband has gone somewhere, but he didn't tell me where did he go to. So this is the nature of love. You feel angry. So you always think that something bad has happened to your beloved. One example is there. Your boy, your son, every day goes to school and he comes back 4 p.m. every day. If one day he's not coming back 4, but he comes back at 5, like if it's not on time back in the house, you'll be so worried, thinking so many bad things. Something happened. Nothing happened actually, but in your mind you'll think so many bad things. Where is my son? Where has he gone to? What happened to him? Is he sick? What happened? Maybe fever, some accident or what? So you think so many bad things. Actually, nothing happened. Your son is playing cricket in the backyard, like in a park, but you're so worried for him. So this is the symptom of love. So in the same way, Lakshmi Devi, she loves her husband, but for 5 days he hadn't sent any message to her, so she was angry. That's why she was angry. Where did he go to? So also there was a presentation of a beautiful drama, Hera Panchami Lila. Mahaprabhu was sitting down with all the devotees. Swarupa Damodara was also present. Srivast Thakur also. Srivast Thakur. And other devotees also. Then Lakshmi Devi, she was there in the play, right? And how was she in the play? She was coming, being carried in a golden palanquin, so dressed up and beautiful. It's explained here.
Sundas sonar palke tini boshechen potike khojte jacchen hen bhagwan giyechen rathe jodi ar lokhi devi kise pore kise chole jacchen
so bhagwan was being carried away in a chariot pulled by ropes
sonar palki
but lakshmi devi was going to trying to find him in a palanquin being carried in a palanquin made of gold and carried by other person
lokhi devi pan chibach
Lakshmi Devi was chewing pan and behind her there was servants, 100 servants, servants, maid servants. One was like fanning her because she was feeling hot, so another fanning with chamar. She was completely ornamented with beautiful ornaments.
ছত্র চামর ধ্বজা পতাকার গণ নানা বাদ্য আগে নাচে দেব দেব দাসী গণ তাম্বুল সম্পূর্ণ ঝারি ব্যজন চামর সাথে দাসী শত হার দীপ্য ভূষাম্বর অনেক ঐশ্বর্য সঙ্গে বহু পরিবার ক্রুদ্ধ হইয়া লক্ষ্মী দেবী আইল সিংহ দ্বার। লক্ষ্মী দেবী এত সুন্দর দাস দাসীর সঙ্গে,
Lakshmi Devi came with many maid servants, like a big crowd of people coming along with her, like just chewing pan, betel nuts, and there was someone to carry a pitcher for her to throw, to spit. It's called pigdani, like someone carrying a pot for her to spit the betel nuts inside. Mahaprabhu saw the scene and he left. He covered his laughter with his hand. Oh, look, she's going to search for her husband. So Lakshmi Devi is like, oh look, I was so crazy looking for you, word for you, and now she's coming with all this, like in gorgeous way and so dressed up. What is this like?
লক্ষ্মীর সঙ্গে দাস দশীগণের প্রাগল্ভ দেখিয়া হাসে মহাপ্রভুগণ মুখে হস্ত দিয়া। মহাপ্রভু নিজের হাতের,
সো মহাপ্রভু কভার্ড হিজ হ্যান্ডস এন্ড কভার্ড হিজ মাউথ এন্ড হি লেফট কত প্রেম কভারিং হিজ মাউথ।
তারপর যে কি,
হোয়াট ইজ দ্য মিনিং,
লক্ষ্মী দেবী কেন এত সাজন সেজেছেন সুন্দর অলংকার,
শি ওয়াজ অল ড্রেসড আপ উইথ বিউটিফুল অল গোল্ডেন অর্নামেন্টস এন্ড এভরিথিং। So actually Lakshmi Devi wants to say, what is Vrindavan? What is this place? Have you been to Vrindavan? Only like some, if you go to Vrindavan, you can see village to village when you go to Vrajamandala Parikrama. In each village, there's some mountains and some
ভুষিগুলো এরকম করে রয়েছে।
আই সরি আই ডিডন্ট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড গুরুদেব স্যার।
ভাঙ্গাচুরা ভাঙ্গাচুরা শুনতে পেয়েছো?
নো
রাস্তাঘাট ভালো না,
লাইক জাস্ট এভরিথিং ইজ লাইক ফুল অফ থর্নস, রোড মেড অফ লাইক
বাবলা কাটা,
লাইক দিস থর্নি ট্রিজ
ব্রজের মধ্যে
যা। ইন ব্রজ দেয়ার ইজ ওয়ান কাইন্ড অফ থর্নি ট্রি
কি বলে
কল্ড,
মানে পায়ে লাগলে দেখা যায় না, খুব যন্ত্রণা করে।
লাইক ইফ ইউ স্টেপ অন দিস থর্ন, ইটস ভেরি স্মল এন্ড ইট উইল ব্লিড সো মাচ।
হ্যাঁ, ঝাড়ি ঝাড়ি কাঁটা রয়েছে। আর তুমি ওইখানে কি করছো?
সো হোয়াই ইউ ওয়ান্ট টু স্টে ইন দিস বৃন্দাবন, লাইক আ ভিলেজ ফুল অফ ডাস্ট এন্ড লাইক ইউ নো লাইক
কাপড় ধুয়ে না। হ্যাঁ, আর ওইখানে তারা দুধ দোহন করে। হ্যাঁ, যারা দুধ দোহন করে না, হ্যাঁ, তাদের একটু কাছে গেলে আপনি বুঝতে পারবেন সুগন্ধ আসে। হ্যাঁ, গরুর দুধের গন্ধ সুগন্ধ আছে। হ্যাঁ, তাই না? আর গোবর মাথায় নিয়ে যায়।
সো দে আর টেকিং দিস কাউ ডাং অন देयर হেডস।
দেখো আমি কত সুন্দর।
ইউ ওয়ান্ট টু স্টে ইন দিস প্লেস?
লক্ষ্মী দেবী,
বাট লুক হাউ আই এম বিউটিফুল।
জগন্নাথ মানে ঠাকুর,
লাইক অ্যাকচুয়ালি লক্ষ্মী দেবী ওয়ান্টেড টু ট্রাই টু মেক কৃষ্ণ আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড। লুক, ইউ লেফট দিস অপুলেন্স অফ বৈকুণ্ঠ এন্ড হোয়াই আর ইউ ইন দিস সিম্পল প্লেস বৃন্দাবন?
ওখানে কি রয়েছে?
হোয়াট ইজ देयर? হোয়াট?
দেখো আমাদের এখানে কত বৈভব।
লুক হাউ মাচ অপুলেন্স ডু আই হ্যাভ।
এত বৈভব ছেড়ে আর ওইখানে কি জন্য গিয়েছো?
এন্ড ইউ লেফট দিস অপুলেন্স এন্ড ইউ আর ইন দিস ডাস্টি প্লেস, লাইক
কাদা রয়েছে,
ফুল অফ থর্নস, আনডেভেলপড প্লেস, বাট ইন বৈকুণ্ঠ এভরিথিং ইজ সো নাইস।
কাদা নাই সেখানে, মাটি নাই। হ্যাঁ, সব
নো মড, নো থর্নস,
এন্ড এত সুন্দর করে রয়েছে।
এভরিথিং ইজ বিউটিফুল এন্ড ওয়েল অ্যারেঞ্জড, ফুল অফ জুয়েলস।
এই হ্যাঁ, মণিমুক্তার দ্বারা রয়েছে বৈকুণ্ঠ ধাম। আর তুমি ওইখানে ওইখানে কি করতে গিয়েছো? এই যে এইটা নিজের ঐশ্বর্য দেখার জন্য।
সো শোইং হার অন অপুলেন্স লক্ষ্মী দেবী, দ্যাটস হোয়াই শি ড্রেসড আপ এন্ড এভরিথিং টু ট্রাই টু শো দ্য অপুলেন্স অফ বৈকুণ্ঠ।
শ্রীবাস তখন বলছেন,
শ্রীবাস অলসো সেড, লুক
তোমার ব্রজের মধ্যে কি রয়েছে?
Then Shivas also said, yeah, because what is in your Vrindavan? Nothing. Cows and gopis are milking cows and gopis are only boiling milk, making butter. But in Vaikuntha, it's a beautiful divine place. Many jewels are there in Vaikuntha.
সেখানে কোনো কাজ করতে হয় না আমাকে, লক্ষ্মী দেবী বস
Lakshmadevi doesn't even need to do anything. She's just sitting down, like with her legs up, like she's like a queen. She doesn't need to do anything. She just sends like a bosses around and everybody does everything. But the gopis, no, the gopis, they are working, like they're milking cows, doing this, doing that. So what is in Vrindavan? Nothing's in Vrindavan, nothing. What? Only flowers and like some trees. But Vaikunth is so full of opulence. Then hearing that, Swarupa Damodara said, Srivas, Srivas is like Narada, right? He's Narada. So he said, look, you glorify Vaikuntha, but actually the opulence of Vrindavan, it's actually, if you put unlimited Vaikuntha planets in one side of a scale, and if you take even only one dust of Vrindavan in the other side of the scale, still will not be the same. Like one dust of Vrindavan is more opulent than unlimited Vaikuntha planets. In our Brahma Samhita, we see
Vaikuntha theke shrestho ki Vaikuntha jonito bara.
Who is Vrindavan is higher than Vaikuntha? And higher than Vrindavan is Giriraj Govardhan. And higher than Giriraj is Radha Kunda.
Vaikunthad janito bara madhupuri tatrapi rasotsava vindarunnam mudarapani. Vaikunthad theke shrestho ki.
What is higher than Vaikuntha? Mathura.
Mathura theke shrestho.
Higher than Mathura, Vrindavan.
Ar Vrindavan theke or shrestho.
And higher than Vrindavan is Giriraj Govardhan. And higher than Giriraj Govardhan is Radha Kunda.
Ekhon ei kothay bolche tai amader Swarup Damodar bolchen je Vrindavaner je mohima tumi kotha ki kore bhule gele.
So Swarup Damodar was saying, actually, even one dust of Vrindavan is not equal to the opulences of Vaikuntha. That's why Brahma Samhita explains. The houses of Vrindavan are made of Chintamani, desire stone. All the houses are built with Chintamani. So, the trees of Vrindavan, they are desired trees. Whatever you think, immediately she will give to you the trees of Vrindavan.
চিন্তামণি প্রকট সদমসু কল্পবৃক্ষ লক্ষাবৃত সুরভি রবির পালয়ন্তম সেখানে গরুগুলো রয়েছে যেন দেখলে মনে হয় যেন সাধারণ গরু.
Like the cows in Vrindavan, they look like ordinary cows.
তামনে গরুগুলোকে কি দেখলে কি মনে হয় সাধারণ গরু.
They look like normal cows, but they are not normal cows.
কি গরু?
These cows are কামধেনু, desire fulfilling cows.
কামধেনু.
And the trees of Vrindavan, the grass of Vrindavan, they are not ordinary. They are kalpa vriksha. Not one, unlimited Lakshmis. They're sweeping there in Vrindavan.
In the
Radha Kripa Kataksha, we see this. Explain. But unlimited Vishnu lokas, they're worshipping the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. Worshipping the glow of the toenails of Srimati Radhika. So what can I tell about the glories of Vrindavan? Swarupa Damodara said, Hey Srivas, did you forget that actually the opulence of Vrindavan is more than the opulence of the unlimited Vaikuntha planets? So all the Vaikuntha together is called Mahavaikuntha. And if you take all the opulence of all the Vaikunthas, it doesn't even compare to one dust of Vrindavan. Like externally, it looks like Vrindavan is a place full of dust and normal, but it's not actually. The gopis are not ordinary people. Who are the gopis? They are the directly bodily expansion, Skyabhyuha of Srimati Radhika. They look like normal cowherd girls, but they are not. Shastra explains. So I am saying this. Lakshmi Devi was going all dressed up and with ornaments and everything, trying to search for her husband. Actually, she wanted to show off the opulence of Vaikuntha. But actually, Vrindavan has so much more opulence than Vaikuntha. Our Raghunath Das Goswami explains. Vrindavan is so glorious, full of opulence. Well, not, but unlimited opulence of unlimited Vaikuntha don't even compare to one dust of Vrindavan. Shastra explains. In Vrindavan, Bhagavan performs Ras Lila. Vrindavan is not an ordinary place. Gopi Gita also we see.
Janmana braja srayat indira shashatrahi daita dichatam dichutavaka traiditashava tvam vichinnate.
Dekho, Indira means Lakshmi.
Indira means Lakshmi. All these Lakshmis, they are sweeping Vrindavan. If Vrindavan would be an ordinary place, so Indira means Lakshmi. Shrayate Indira. Indira means Mahalakshmi. So this Mahalakshmi, who is she? Srimati Radhika. Many meanings. Normal meaning is that Lakshmi means Lakshmi.
Shrayate Indira. Vrindavaner mahima ke varnan korbo.
What can I describe about the glories of Vrindavan? What Jamuna Devi is flowing with the sound kal 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 kal. Beautiful Vrindavan Dham. Krishna in Vrindavan performed so many pastimes. But Lakshmi Devi, she was trying to show off, look my beautiful form, look at the opulence of Vaikuntha. But actually the opulence of Vrindavan is many, 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 many times more. So time is up. I will stop. So in this way, Lakshmi Devi was coming. And what was she doing also?
Srivas hasiya koi suno damodar amar lakshmi devi dekho sampatti vistar vrindavaner sampad dekho puspa kishaloy gridhatu shiki bichcha gunja phol moy vrindavan dekhibare gela jagannath suni lakshmi devir mone hoilo aswat asuman irsha holo.
So aswat means like envy,
eto vaikuntha sampatti chhede.
So how possible Krishna left this opulence of Vaikuntha and he's in Vrindavan with these flowers and fruits and this simple place? There's only jungle.
Suni Lakshmi Devi mane hoilo ashwas. Eto sampati chhari ke kena gela Vrindavan. Tare hasya korite Lakshmi korilo sajon. Tomar thakur dekho eto sampati chhari. Patra phul lobhe gela pushpa bari. Ei karma korete ho bidagdha shiromane Lakshmi agrete nijo prabhute deho ani. Eto bole Lakshmi sab das dasi gane. কোটি বস্ত্রে বাঁধি আনে প্রভুর নিজ গণে লক্ষ্মী চরণে আনি তাহার করায় প্রণতি ধনদণ্ড লয় আর করায় মিনতি এখন লক্ষ্মী দেবী কি করলেন জগন্নাথ দেবকে
লক্ষ্মী দেবী
বলেন কোথায় গেল আমার পতি কোথায়
লুকিয়ে Where's my husband? Why did you hide them? Him. Lakshmi was searching for Jagannath. Then all the servants of Jagannath. No, Lakshmi Devi, she's queen. So she's told to arrest all of them and started to chastise the servants of Jagannatha. Why are you keeping my husband? So everyone was bound, chastised, all the servants of Jagannatha by the servants of Lakshmi Devi. Okay, but 2-4 more days, I will come back. So the 5th day, and when Jagannatha comes back, is on the... After 7 days. So after 4 days. So 5 days has been since Jagannath came back, came out. And on the 10th day of the moon, on the day of Ekadashi, Jagannath comes back.
দশমীতে তিনি ঠাকুর ফিরে আসেন আর একাদশীতে এসে শয়ন করেন এই একাদশী থেকে আসবে কি শয়ন একাদশী
সো দিস নেক্সট একাদশী শয়ন একাদশী
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আউট মানে তিথি কম বেশি আগে পিছে হওয়ার জন্য
সামটাইমস দ্য তিথি চেঞ্জ লিটল বিট
বাট সেটা হচ্ছে দশমীতে ঠাকুর ফিরে আসে
জেনারেলি ইন দ্য দশমী জগন্নাথ কামস ব্যাক টু দ্য টেম্পল অফ জগন্নাথ
একাদশীতে
So on the Kadashi, the deity goes to take rest. He was tired and then takes rest. This lila is very beautiful. So these lilas in Jagannatha Puri, Mahaprabhu was there in Puri and he also observed this. This is Haira Panchami. Many Tata Siddhanta in this lila, Rasa Madhurya. And what is Swakya, Parakya, what is Bhamma, Bhav, opposite mode, Sakya mode, and Lakhin Bhav, submission mode. Slowly, slowly, we describe all this. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita we see especially this Rasa Madhurya about the Ratha Yatra. So for some chapters in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, actually some chapters are the hearts of the Gaudiya Vaishnavas. The 4th chapter of the Adi Lila was speaking about Srimati Radhika, another is the Rupa Shiksha, Sanatana Shiksha also, and Ratayata Prasanga, this context of Ratayata Kata and Rai Ramananda also. These are like the heart of the Gaudiya Vaishnavas in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So about the Ratayata, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he spoke so well, so beautiful Rasa Madhurya. So if you study, you can enter this rasa and you'll feel so much bliss, happiness. So Ujjalinilamani also explains. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami also described this so well in his book, Chaitanya Charitamrita. So like this, in this way, the Chaitanya Charitamrita is a priceless book, unparalleled book. If you read Chaitanya Charitamrita, you don't need to read any other book. So the essence of all the Upanishads, Bhagavatam is the Bhagavatam, right? essence of all the Vedas. So the fruit, the ripened fruit of the Veda, desire tree of the Vedas is the Srimad Bhagavatam. But like the essence, but the essence of the Bhagavatam is the Chaitanya Charitamrita. If you want to relish the rasa madhurya of the Bhagavatam, certainly you must do through Chaitanya Charitamrita. Because the Chaitanya Charitamrita, actually in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, you'll find all the books are of our Goswamis inside. So Chaitanya Charitamrita is a priceless book and an unparalleled book. There's no book like the Chaitanya Charitamrita in this whole world. Full of all Tata Siddhanta, Rasa Siddhanta, is in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, is inside the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has manifested this unparalleled book. Humbly, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami said, "It wasn't me that wrote this book. I'm already so old. My hand is shaking because of old age. Krishna Madana Mohan, Krishna caught my hand and he's writing. I could not write." But Madana Mohan directly, you know Madana Mohan from Vrindavan, Krishna, he has caught my hand and he's writing this book. So who is the actual writer of Chaitanya Charitamrita? The author is Swayam Madan Mohan, Krishna himself. See. So if someone criticizes the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the person is the most sinner person in whole world. There is in Bengal some person, some person in Bengal that are speaking, criticizing, seeing bad things about the Chaitanya Charitamrita. This person, there's no sinner, this is the most sinner person of the whole world. Someone criticizes Srivastava Thakur. Who? Chapal Gopal. Then Mahaprabhu gave leprosy to Chapal Gopal. Wasn't it? Now imagine someone who criticizes Chaitanya Charitamrita, written by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. If someone says something against this book and the author, how Mahaprabhu would tolerate that? You can think about this. So who is Krishnadas Kaviraj? He is directly the eternal associate Manjari, Kausturi Manjari of Srimati Radhika. Which Manjari? Kausturi Manjari. Isn't it? So these Manjaris, Krishna himself is bowing his head at the feet of these Manjaris, praying to them, doing Dandavat Pranam to the feet of these Manjaris, Krishna himself. So imagine. Prabodhana Sarasvati wrote, Krishna, he's in Nidivan, Vrindavan. And Srimati Radhika, she was in man, angry, sulky, and Srimati Radhika closed the door of the kunja, she shut the door, and the manjaris are in the door of the kunja, Rupa manjari, Kasturi manjari, and so Krishna is folding his hand at the feet of the manjaris. Please allow me to meet Srimati Radhika. Then they say, today it's not, won't be possible, get out, go away. So if someone criticizes these manjaris, just imagine how Krishna will be able to tolerate that, how Mahaprabhu will tolerate that, what will he do? If someone criticizes Srivastava Thakur and you saw the consequences, Mahaprabhu gave leprosy to that person for 7 lives, not 1 life. Mahaprabhu said, for 7 lives, the person will have leprosy, not for 1 life. See? Leprosy. So he was living in the banks of the Ganges and his body was so disgusting. Mahaprabhu, every day he used to go to bathe in the Ganges. And Chapal Gopal would pray, please forgive my offense, please forgive my offense. Mahaprabhu said, no, I won't forgive you. You have criticized my Srivastava Thakur, you have criticized him. You're saying that Srivastava Thakur was worshipping Devi and doing some things. You put this paraphernalia for Devi Puja in front of his house just so that people would think he was worshipping Devi and drinking and doing some things. So you have criticized Srivas. Srivas was doing kirtan the whole night. And you are trying to like to allegate to say that he was worshiping Devi in So Mahaprabhu gave leprosy to him. So imagine someone tells something against Kasturi Manjari, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. He manifested this wealth of prema in the like the Chaitanya Charitamrita for the Gaudiya Vaishnavas. So if someone tells anything against Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Chaitanya Charitamrita, Mahaprabhu won't ever be able to tolerate that. The person certainly will be punished by God. Certainly the person will be punished. So beautiful Chaitanya Charitamrita. The pranadhan, the life heirs of the Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Actually, Chaitanya Charitamrita is nothing less than the Bhagavatam. Nothing less than the Bhagavatam. Chaitanya Charitamrita is the unparalleled. So Shukadeva Goswami couldn't even describe about the Mahabhava of Srimati Radhika in the Bhagavatam. But Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he told about all this Mahabhava of Srimati Radhika, this highest mood. So this unparalleled book and some foolish person is telling something against the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So be careful. Be careful to not commit any offense. Especially, why I'm saying this? So the Chaitanya Charitamrita explains beautiful katha about the Ratha Yatra. This is the heart of the Gaudiya Vaishnavas. These divine pastimes of Mahaprabhu in the Gambhira. All these lilas are described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So if someone criticizes Chaitanya Charitamrita, you should be very far from that person. Bolo Vrindavana Bihari Lal Ki Jai.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
The heart of Chaitanya Charitamrita for the Gaudiya Vaishnavas. I mean, the heart of Gaudiya Vaishnavas in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Chapter 4, Adi Lila. Then also Rupa Shiksha, Sanatana Shiksha. And also the Ratha Yatra Katha in the Madhya Lila. And also the Raya Ramananda Samvad. Jai Sri Ram. Jai Sri Gurudev.